Welcome to the Burden and Blessing Podcast, a study and discussion forum on the truth of God's Word. Our Word of the Week takes an in-depth look at important Bible words so we might increase and deepen our understanding of God's Word of Truth. We pray that these brief studies will enable you to get more out of your daily reading and hearing of God's Holy Word.
This is Nathanael Mayhew, back with you today for another Word of the Week on Burden and Blessing. Over the last few weeks, we have been considering various names of Jesus found both in the Old and the New Testament. The name which we are looking at this week is one of the most common names for Jesus in the Bible. It is the name Son of God. As we consider this term Son of God, it's important that we begin by recognizing what many throughout history have believed about the term Son of God. If we go into Greek mythology, for example, there are many of the gods of the Greeks that have children that are half human and half God. For example, Perseus was the son of Zeus, but he was not full God, he was only half God. He was what was called a demigod. There are many who look at Jesus in a similar way. They would see Jesus as only a partial God or a demigod. And so as we consider this term Son of God, we want to look at what Scripture says about the term Son of God as a title for Jesus, and also the Jewish view of what Jesus meant when he was called, or when he called himself, the Son of God. It's interesting to note as we consider this term, where the name is used and by whom throughout the Gospels. Mark begins his Gospel with the statement that Jesus is the Son of God. He says, "The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God." The same title was also used by the angel Gabriel when he came to announce the birth of Jesus to his mother Mary. The angel Gabriel says, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore also that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God." Because Jesus was going to be conceived by the Holy Spirit, the angel says that he would have the title or the name, the Son of God. Now, throughout the ministry of Jesus, this name continued on. John the Baptist declared Jesus to be the Son of God. He said, "I have seen and testified that this is the Son of God," speaking about Jesus. As Jesus continued his ministry, we see that Nathanael made the same confession. After meeting Jesus, Nathanael said, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God, the King of Israel." At the end of the ministry of Jesus, at the death of his good friend Lazarus, Lazarus's sister Martha made the same confession, saying, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is come into the world." As the disciples confronted a storm on the Sea of Galilee, and Jesus comes walking across the water and calms the storm, we're told that they confessed, "Truly, you are the Son of God." But it wasn't just the disciples of Jesus, the followers of Jesus, that confessed him to be the Son of God. We're told that after the death of Jesus, after the Roman centurion saw all of the events surrounding his death, even this unbeliever, up to this point, confessed and said, "Truly, this was the Son of God." Even the demons throughout the ministry of Jesus spoke of Jesus as the Son of God. In one instance in the Gospel of Matthew, we're told that the demons cried out and said, "What have we to do with you, Jesus, you Son of God? Have you come to torment us before the time?" Even the demons recognized Jesus as the Son of God. Finally, it was this very confession, this very acknowledgement of who Jesus was, that ended up bringing about Jesus' crucifixion. On the night before Jesus' death, he was put under oath by the high priest, who asked, "Tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God." Matthew tells us that Jesus responded, saying, "It is as you said." As a result of this admission that he was the Son of God, he was condemned to death because of blasphemy. And it is really this fact that is most important in our study of the term Son of God. Jesus was not simply declaring to be a half-God or a demigod. It was the fact that he was declaring himself to be the very God, the one and only God, that finally brought about his condemnation and death. Jesus is the Son of God. He is true God as well as true man. Over 40 times in the New Testament, this term is used to describe the divine nature of Jesus of Nazareth. Praise be to God that Jesus is more than just a man, but our God and our Savior, come in the flesh to save us from our sins.
We encourage you to listen for a new word each week on Burden and Blessing Podcast, where we believe and confess that every word of God is true. Until next week, be assured that God's word is truth and is more precious than gold.